Hello and welcome to HMS TechTalks. Today we're going to talk about charging of electrical vehicles and what's going on when it comes to communication between an electrical vehicle and on the other side a building system or some kind of automation system. And with me to discuss that today we have Ignacio Garcia Sanchez from our Intesis business unit. So first of all, welcome Ignacio.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Thomas, for having me today.
We've all been accustomed to electrical vehicles and even charging them. But when you plug in an electrical vehicle, what's actually going on between the car and the charging station? What's the communication that's going on there?
Well, to understand a little bit the different type of communications, we need to first understand that there are different types of charging in the cars. We have AC charging, and we have DC charging. DC charging basically connects directly the electric connection to the battery management system inside of the car. And if we are looking at the AC charging, we need to have something in between, which is sits in the car and translates the AC signal to the battery management system signal. To understand if there's a communication going on between the car and the charging station, we need to also understand that there are different type of modes in the AC charging and DC charging. Depending on the mode, we will have a faster way of loading the battery or a quicker way. There are different modes in the industry: mode 2, mode 3. In DC, we have the mode 4, and that type of mode enables a way to connect to the car and some communication between the car, the battery management system, and the charging point. But this communication is very, very simple. It's typically uses two different type of pins in the connectors. To know if there is a car connected to the connector is a proximity pin, and then we have a pilot pin. And this pilot pin basically only offers simple communication, as in, okay, my battery is charged or is not charged, or my battery is on 20%, or now to 30%, or to 40%. But as I said, this communication is quite simple. And the intelligence is mostly sitting behind in the charging point, in the charging station.
Right. Okay. So there's not so much communication going on, except the electrical charging. But what are the standards we're dealing here? What are the communication standards for EV charging, and what do they need to communicate with on the other side?
Well, to understand how do we connect, or how we can connect the different type of EV charging stations or cars, we need to understand that first of all, that this industry, the electric vehicle industry, is relatively new. And let's say that not so long ago, there was just a few manufacturers in the industry that were providing their solutions to the market, but they were not a real need of communicate with each other, right? This this industry is growing really fast, and we can see that it is being pushed by governments, by regulations, by the manufacturers themselves. And like in any let's say industry that has many manufacturers, they have to communicate with each other. They need to talk to each other, right? And that is why the need of standards in the market is also relatively new. For example, back in 2009, there was a Dutch association created the Open Charge Alliance. And those were the ones who created the OCPP protocol, which is one of the communication standards in the industry to communicate between charging stations, charging poles, and everything that is around that. As I said, back in 2009, the Open Charge Alliance developed the OCPP, the Open Charge Point Protocol, the version 1.5. Today, the most used version, I would say, in the market is the 1.6. It's most spread around the market. And there are new versions coming on, coming up, like the 2.0, that will help to support new challenges in the future, like, for example, identification and communication between different the car and the charging points. There are other standards out there, but they are more focused perhaps into the type of the communication of the car and the charging points. For example, the CHAdeMO Alliance is also, they develop a standard. There's a Japanese association that develop a standard for DC charging that enables communication between the car and the charger. And for example, in this case, it's based on CAN, and they can offer more intelligence than the one I mentioned before, that is only, okay, here's my my battery level, and that's it.
Right, so CHAdeMO has a bit more communication going on between the car and the system, right?
Correct. But if we look at the integration of the building and or, for example, the different electric vehicles charging points manufacturers, there is another standard. And that is quite new as well, is the EEBUS. And this is a new standard that is mostly focused on energy energy management in buildings. And since energy is a big, let's say, topic, a hot topic in the EV industry, this standard helps to communicate not only the EV charging in the building or in the house, but also all the energy related technologies in the building. Could be power generation from solar panels, or it could be consumption of energy in the building, like lighting or HVAC.
Right, and we know that Intesis provides protocol conversion between a lot of building automation systems, but if we look at the users, who are actually asking for these kind of solutions? Is it the building owners, or is it the car manufacturers, or who are the users here?
Well, I think the integration, or the let's say the protocol, or the conversion between the what is going on in the electric vehicle charging station and the building is interesting for both. It's interesting for building owners to have control of the energy and the power that is being consumed in the building. There are actually new regulations in the market that are enabling building owners to generate their own energy in the building and being able to sell it or to promote it to the tenants living in the building, right? And in order to do so, these technologies, they need to communicate. They need to communicate between what is the management system of the building and the energy that is being consumed by the electric stations. Because you need to make sure as well that you can provide enough power for all the installation. And that is where new standards, let's say, are coming up in the industry to enable vehicle to grid energy. Some new trends in the market allowed the even the battery of the car that comes to be charged in a building to transport energy back to the building. So this is a concept completely the other way around. But these technologies and these trends are there and are interesting for the building owners, but also for the charging point manufacturers.
Right. So a lot of different interest groups there when it comes to translation between the electrical vehicle and the building automation system. Interesting. So if we get a little bit more technical here, how does it actually work when you translate the different standards? What do you need to do to set it up?
Well, if we are looking at the OCPP standard, we can use a Modbus gateway, an OCPP-to-Modbus gateway, to enable that communication between the BMS and the charging point. In the OCPP technology, we can talk a little bit techy about this, but you need to have a central system and a charging station, or a charging point, sorry. When we translate what is going on between the charging point and the BMS, when we place a gateway there, the gateway, together with the building management system, is becoming a central system in the OCPP installation. And the dialogue looks like something like this. a user arrives with the car to the charging point, and then it passes the RFID card, and then the charging point tells the gateway, hey, I have a user with an RFID card that wants to charge the car. Then the gateway communicates with the BMS using Modbus commands with the information about the RFID card, so the information of the user, and that they want to initiate that, that transaction. The BMS, if is in charge of the whole operation, perhaps it has in the backend a list of RFID cards, RFIDs, that are allowed to charge in that specific charging point. So it will review and create a logic behind, and then it will reply back to the gateway saying, yeah, there's no problem, you can start the charge. And then the gateway, using OCPP communication, will tell the OCPP, the charging point, yes, you may start the charge. And in that process, it will communicate back to the gateway and again back to the system with information like the power being used or the battery level or if there's any problem during the charge. And once the charging point has reached the battery level has reached 100%, it will request to stop the charge. That communication will go back to the BMS and forward to the charging point to stop the charge, and then the process is done. I hope that was not too techy.
No, perfect. Great. So thanks a lot, Ignacio, for letting us in a little bit on the communication that goes on between electrical vehicles and building automation systems.
My pleasure. It was really nice talking to you.